just to make it clear, there's no course that I'm gonna sell. So yeah, just to add that in, there's no mention of course in this entire video, because I've seen other videos wherein people say that, you know, they've been earning this much at such a young age, and then they go on to list some kind of course that they're selling. No, bitch, I'm not gonna do that. This video is purely based on my experience that I've gotten in these past 2 years. You can't even say 2 years, it's almost 2 years. Let's go ahead and start with my first job, my first salary, and how I started working, first of all. So I had no plans of working. My plan was actually to get into Harvard or something. But then COVID, and then, you know, plan flopped. There was a big financial crisis that my family was facing, and there was a big dip in my life as well. I mean, it was just not a good phase that I was going through. And then I realized that, you know, I had to start working, and I had just completed my 12. I did go to an interview that was in Malad, I think. But before I could even give the interviewer asked me for my documents of my 12th certificate. And I'm like, wait, I don't have that yet, but I'll be receiving it in like a month. They're like, come after a month then. So I was heartbroken because I didn't get that job. And after that, I did get a job in Cytel, almost. So I had cleared the HR round, the Q&A round, and I was in the final round of the interview, the ops round. And the interviewer, he was about to like welcome me on board, and suddenly he's like, wait, what's your date of birth? And I said, it's 1st of July 2004. He's like, you're not 18 yet. I'm like, okay, how does that matter? He's like, you know, this is child labor, right? And I'm like, I should have been informed that in my first or the second round of interview. They shouldn't have cleared me and, you know, passed it on to you before. They should have told me beforehand that, you know, this is not possible because you're not of the right age. And I got to know that when I was in a final round of interview. For some reason, the interviewer, he got very impressed with me. He's like, wait, I kind of like you. And he's like, on the 1st of July, when you turn 18, give me a call back. We'll do the third round of interview once again, and I'll clear you, and then we'll give you a job, this, that. Anyway, did not go for that company again because I got another company and it was nearby. So I live in Naigaon and Cytel is in Andheri, I believe. Yeah, it's in Andheri. That's a lot of travel for me. So on 1st of July, after I turned 18, I think on the 2nd or the 3rd of 2nd of July is when I gave my interview, and this was in Epicenter. God bless that company. I personally love it. People, I mean, I don't name people or, you know, say stuff, but this is something that other people have told me. They have not had the best experience. It's the personal experience I'm talking about, but for me, it was amazing, fantastic. Personal and work experience was amazing for me. The work was very easy. The salary was less, but of course, it was justifiable because I was a fresher and the process was very easy. So the salary was justifiable. So to start with, 2nd of July, I gave my interview, and from 5th of July was my joining. I worked until the 6th of July of 2023. That's exactly 1 year. During that period, or when I was in Epicenter, my salary was 15,000, around that, 15,600. I was ecstatic. I mean, it was my first job, my first salary. It was a call center job, you know, because I did not have any other degree and all that. Plus, I had just done my 12th. I was not even a graduate. So for graduates, I believe they were offering about 21, or I think with negotiation, 25, I'm not sure. But for freshers, there's no negotiation factor included. 15,000 with like 3K incentives. And the incentives, it was like 10 different parameters that you had to meet. If you don't meet that, then no incentives, something like that. So I'm going to consider only my basic salary, which was around 15,000. So we started out with that. And as I mentioned, I completed 1 year. As soon as my 1 year was complete, I started looking for other jobs, because also, just to mention, because my performance was really good, they really liked my performance. I got an early increment, which was, I think they increased my salary up to 24,000 with incentives. So that's 21,000 basic salary. And this was done within 8 or 9 months of me working there. right? So they increased my salary and I was at 21k. Now my plan was that I would work for another 3 months over there, because when you apply to any other company, they will ask you for the last 3 payslips, that last 3 months payslips. That is the reason I planned it accordingly. I had strategized it. I worked for another 3 months, zero confidence going into this job. The only reason why I could crack the interview for my first job was because it was over the phone. Like, all 3 rounds of the interview were over the phone. And I had kind of like messed up, but then, you know, I'm good with my words. Like, I can write and then I can read that stuff back, right? I cannot just make stuff up instantaneously. I'm not good with, you know, promptly saying things, but I had written down the entire things for the interview, like tell me something about yourself and all those interview questions. I had already prepared paragraphs for it, and I had watched a lot of YouTube videos. I had watched a lot of YouTube videos that helped me a ton, and I was prepared, I would say. Like, a whole entire day, I was just going through all the interview questions. I had written down what I want to say. I had memorized it because I was not confident with how I would speak in front of the interviewer. I was just so nervous, so scared, shitless. Epicent is like the company where freshers come, they take experience, they go. I mean, that's just the harsh reality. Same for me. I did work for 1 year and I left with 21,000 being my salary. Then I got into First Source. That's the American Express process. And that was, and even my previous company, I was in collections, which was software collections. But in this one, it was hardcore collections in First Source. And there, I got a package of, it was 35,000. If I am able to, I might put up my offer letter right here. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to or not, but I'll maybe block out all the personal or important information and just show you that salary part. So I got a salary of 35,000, which was a huge jump. And yeah, on 6th of July, we celebrated. All my friends had come, they had brought cars. We went to a beach to celebrate my last day at the office, and then they had brought cakes and all. It was so fun. We danced around. It was 3 or 4 in the morning. After that, began the new journey. That's in First Source. And I left on 6th of July. And I only left once I had gotten the confirmation about my new job, which is also very important that people miss. They just leave their job and then start applying. Don't do that. It's going to mess you up if you don't get a job. Apply first, get the job, then, you know, put your notice letter, or that's when you quit it, right? So I did the same. After I was confirmed, and I was in my notice period. The notice is for 30 days in Epicenter, and I had not applied for the job when I put the notice letter, because even if I had not gotten the new job, I can just go ahead and revoke my notice. That is the reason I was already in my notice period, and then in the midst of it, I got to know that I had gotten accepted to the other company, and that's when I, you know, continued with my notice, and I think only 15 days were remaining. Completed that, and 6th of July was the last day at Epicenter, and then now in First Source, I work for about 3 months. I'll tell you why. Again, I don't mean to bash any company, and of course, it's not good to badmouth the company which was paying you, but it is what it is, right? And it wasn't the company. Like, people were really good. Like, people were really supportive, and they were really good. It's just the process was not for me. Personally, I didn't like it. There were people that had been working there for 17 years in the same process. But that process was not for me, and I was not, you know, feeling satisfied with my work. I mean, I was doing good with my performance. I didn't feel satisfied on the inside. And I had to, of course, complete 3 months, because again, some companies do ask for the last 3 months, last 3 payslips. That is the reason I completed 3 months over there. And once I did, that's when I applied for... Can you even see it? Is it mirrored? It's like this. No, you cannot see it. It's JPMorgan Chase. Bought through conviction. It that point, I think I had contacted Connection HR, and then I got with them, and then I got to know that it's not a collection process. I needed to get into collections. I wanted collections, but then there was customer service available. Like the day I went for interview, that day itself, the interview for collections had gotten over, and customer service was available. And I'm so glad that I went into customer service, and I'm so glad that collections interviews were over on that specific day. And the lucky thing is that particular day, I had gone on a Saturday, I remember. The interviewers were telling me how, you know, lucky our batch was, because there was no HR round that day, because it was a Saturday. HRs do not work on a Saturday. We didn't do that interview. We had the main ops interview was done first, and then for Q&A interview, they told us that if we get selected in the ops interview, they will call us tomorrow or the day after tomorrow for the Q&A round. So I went for the ops interview, and you know, I left confidently that yeah, I'm gonna get the job, but I was not fully confident. I mean, I will tell you one thing, one trick to get the job is to make the interviewer laugh. That's what I did, and I didn't know that they would announce the results the next day. So when I didn't get the call the whole day, like, I was depressed in my room. I was like, shit, I got rejected. I'd never been rejected. That's when I got to know that they announced the results the next day. And I didn't even get to know that. I got to know that once I got the result the next day. And then like, oh yeah, you've been selected. And it was such a relief. I was so happy. My mom and I, we were dancing around. That day, I went to the office to give the Q&A round. And my HR that was guiding me through the whole process, he's like, be calm. It's only like, you know, if it's like 10 people, 5 are going to get rejected. So don't panic. I was so scared. But I'll tell you something, fake it till you make it always works. I faked being relaxed, and I did wonderful in the interview. I did so good. I made her laugh, and she was so content with me and taking some confidence. It gave me confidence somehow. The next day is when I got the message that I had been selected. I believe there were like 25 people that had interviewed and only 3 had gotten selected. The package. Yeah, I got a call from the HR at JP, and at first she's like, okay, keeping in mind that your previous organization's salary package was this LPA. I'm like, wait, no, you're considering my salary for Epicenter. Please look at my salary slip for First Source. And then she's like, oh wait, did you work in another company? I'm like, yeah. Let me send you the slip right now. And I sent her the slip, and then she revised the salary package, and now it was 52,000. And let me tell you, the added benefits, bro. The night shift allowance, which is like around 7,000 if you're doing a later shift, and then the fucking leave travel allowance, the other benefits, the leaves that you get. It's been amazing since then. And I also do overtime now. Salary's good, y'all. The work is good. The work is difficult. I mean, it is JP, but you get used to it, right? And you feel good because you know you're going to get the salary at the end of the month. That's like the motivation I go for. Anyway, this July, I will complete 2 years of working. I'm going to try distance learning once again because I do need to complete my graduation so that I can move on to becoming a team leader in the future. It's been 6 months. That means the probation period is over and we are permanent now. And it's been going good, y'all. And they're telling me that I'm the youngest employee all over the JP centers. Best part is your relatives, your family being so proud of you, and them mentioning again and again that, you know, the baby of the family is earning this much at this age. It's the best thing to hear. Yeah, I just want to talk about it. There's no course. There's no fucking course that's gonna salary in your account. You just have to work for it. It's not that difficult. Now that I think about these two years, they have been kind of like a blur. I do want to make some more like job related videos. So if anyone has any recommendations, any type of video that they... There's literally no subscribers. Who am I talking to? Oh my god. Here's the camera. I've been looking here. I've been looking at my own fucking face for the last 24 minutes.